On this episode of Make It Real, we're trying something different. We're making the Blitz Shield from Rainbow Six. Do you guys remember Riley? He started volunteering here about a year ago. When he graduated high school this spring, we actually hired him on full-time for the summer to help out around the shop before he heads to Conestoga College to follow in our footsteps in becoming an engineer.
Riley here just graduated from high school, and as per tradition, he's burning some of his old notes and starting a full-time job at Hacksmith Industries.
Anyway, employees here at Hacksmith Industries get to work on their own projects occasionally too. So without further ado, here's Riley's Blitz Shield build. Big thank you to Wix for sponsoring this video, but more on that later.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Riley Makes It Real.
Whoa, this might be your project, but this is my wall.
Okay. Okay, so the reason I really wanted to try this project was because I play a lot of Rainbow Six Siege, and I wanted to see if it was possible to make a similarly bulletproof shield that is also usable, and I guess we're gonna find out if it's really as easy to flip it sideways and fire on the enemies as the game makes it look. So let's check out the design. So judging by the CAD model right now, it's probably not going to be wieldy because it's supposed to be about 110 pounds, but let's make it anyways. I'm going to be using the new Maverick CNC plasma table to cut this out, which makes my job super easy. The machine was provided by Elite Metal Tools, which is like the Amazon of industrial machinery, with tons of products and free shipping.
Without my hammer, I come. Another!
That's heavy.
Not worthy,
then you shouldn't
be touching the hammer. Another! It's actually lovely. I believe in miracles!
Where from? Thor's hammer is going so useful.
And in the report?
Oh my god, Thor's hammer is awesome. And
what did you do?
I'm an idiot. I got a bend. It's quarter inch steel around this.
Good luck with that.
That's not gonna be fun.
We'll be right back.
So we're going to be measuring the peak brightness of the Blitz Shield LED assembly using this light meter here. And I've got it set to record the maximum that it gets to. And we'll see how bright this is compared to some other things, welding, the sun outside, and you know, maybe some other stuff too. As you can see, we got to 1635.
So now we're outside. It's about 10 degrees out, which is pretty warm for Canada in the spring. And it's about 4 p.m. and we're gonna see how bright it is from the sun. Yeah. What was that?
That one.
Flicker it on again. Yeah, that's all of them.
Like much higher than the others.
Turn it off.
Okay. It's like an IMAX. How hot are those?
130 Celsius. I think we need proper cooling. Alright, pull up.
Oh, yeah, it's getting dimmer.
That one was wrong.
Yes, it was getting dimmer. Just that one.
Well, yeah, I hit 134 Celsius.
Yes.
Quality control. Quality control.
This video is sponsored by Wix, a free platform that allows you to build highly customizable, professional, and robust websites. You can use the simple drag and drop tools to create a beautiful website quickly and easily. Or if you're a seasoned pro, Wix code allows you to do even more. With total creative freedom using Wix, you can build a website for almost any purpose. From portfolios to personal brands, it's even got you covered for a professional business site. Plus, with hundreds of free templates, it's a great way to get your website online. We're currently working on revamping our website, and we chose Wix to do it right. Once we're done, we'll have full project pages with more information about each project, so you can learn even more about how we make our projects. So, if you guys want to make an awesome website too, click on my link in the description below and go to Wix.com to get started today.
Yeah, we'll have to take it to the gun range and unload some 9mm on it.
I agree.
Make it look a bit worn torn.
Here, grab that.
Which arm? This arm?
Yeah. Yep. There you go. Twist your arm backwards.
This is definitely not comfortable.
That was hot.
Oh yeah, by the way, I forgot to mention, I literally just welded that.
Now you can charge.
Thank you.
Valhalla. What I'm doing, I'm sharing to Instagram. So you guys can see projects before the videos come out. Isn't that great?
Now for an extra special technique, both light and paint at the same time.
So it's going to be the first functional test of the shield fully assembled, and hopefully it's going to work. Right now I'm using a sketchy relay setup because Bogdan's going to wire up a really cool switch next week. Now there are two ways this can go. It's either going to make a really big spark or it's going to work. And I don't know which one's gonna happen.
Evan, you really might wanna close your eyes for this one.
They're closed.
All right.
Do it.
Get me mounted. Back. Oh fuck!
Ah!
Nice work, Riley.
Oh my god, that is.
Denied.
If you guys enjoy our projects and want to help support the channel, consider following us on social media like Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Plus, you get to see sneak peeks of projects before the videos even come out. And you can even give us feedback and suggestions for those projects as we're building them, like this one. So what Naomi was talking about was an LCD light valve. And it's basically this little LCD panel that when you apply a voltage to, it darkens. Now these are most commonly used in welding helmets to protect your eyes from welding flashes. What we're going to do is make an array of these on the bulletproof glass of the Blitz Shield so you don't blind yourself while you're strobing your enemies.
Show everything. It's what the fans want, Bogdan.
It's what the fans want.
So, a really cool feature we've got is this, the auto-dimming LCD panel, which works in the exact opposite of the light.
For more information on how electronics works, please check out our circuit diagram at maker.io. There are links in the description below.
Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed the build video. It was a riot to create.
Riley, you know our policy on puns.
Yeah.
So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed that project. Let us know what you thought about it in the comments below. But make sure you're subscribed with notifications turned on, because we are going to take this to an airsoft game to see if it's actually functional, and we're also going to take it to a gun range and shoot it. So make sure you're subscribed. Thanks for watching.